Well, my friends, this is a quick take on something that's near and dear to my heart and perhaps the most logical choice in the segment. This is the Volkswagen Golf R. Now, in terms of logical, this thing is very easy to live with, especially here in the city. You can park it anywhere, goes anywhere, and as you can see in the back, I've got it filled with bicycle. So it's a very practical machine, but on the other hand, it does have a broad performance envelope. The R uses Volkswagen's familiar 2-liter 4-cylinder turbo, and the company says it makes 292 horsepower and 280 pounds of torque. But that's a lie. The aftermarket and enthusiast community have indeed discovered that it makes a little bit more than those numbers. You can find out those on your own, but the consensus seems to be that the official numbers are a wee bit pessimistic. There's the 6-speed dual-clutch gearbox, of course, which definitely doesn't get the credit that it's due, and helping get all of this excessive power to the ground is the all-wheel drive system, or 4Motion in VW speak. The thing is with this Golf R, it does everything so well that it's darn near perfect, but on the other hand, it doesn't leave me with this burning desire to get up every morning and jump in behind the wheel. The thing is, because it's so easy to live with, so easy to drive, it's the right size for me, fits in my garage, easy to drive in the city, has a massive performance envelope, it just makes a lot of sense for me. On the other hand, like my pal Russell says, and he's got one of these in white, of course, that this is the modern sleeper. It's invisible in traffic, especially in white, not this car's color, but in white, it just looks like any other 5-door, and that idea really appeals to me. Here's the thing about this Golf R, it's got drive modes, comfort, normal, race, and individual, where you can set your own settings for all sorts of things like DCC, steering, drivetrain, ACC, adaptive front lighting, and my favorite, interior engine sound. If that means, that means it makes fake engine noises in here. As well, there is another function which I think is also lame. It's a lap timer. Yes, a lap timer, believe it or not. I don't get it. This car is not equipped. It's not fitted with the right stuff to do fast laps around any kind of circuit, so I don't understand why it would have a lap timer, but hey, I guess it sells 3 or 4 cars, so whatever. All right, my friends. Listen to that fake engine noise. Now, of course, the dual-clutch gearbox shifts so seamlessly, and it's so quick. I mean, if you're like me and live in an urban environment and get stuck in traffic like this nonsense, you'll want the dual-clutch gearbox without question. Sure, the manual might be more interesting from time to time, but now the dual clutch is seemingly flawless. And for a hatchback, man, you can really point this thing. I really, really like it. Yeah, this thing just hustles. Of course, who doesn't love a flawless downshift with a nice blip of the throttle? Interesting. All right. So we've got a car that turns in really well, responds to mid-corner throttle corrections. Not that you want to be doing that, especially if you're not so experienced, but the chassis does respond well to that, and that is a good thing for drivers like us. Of course, with electric power steering, there's not a lot of feedback through the steering wheel, but thankfully it's very precise and makes the Golf R very, very controllable. Like a little better initial response out of the brake pedal, but otherwise, it's quite good and very, very predictable. Don't know if I'm a big fan of the fake engine noise, though. That's a little annoying, but otherwise, this Golf R is a fun little handler. I do like the damping on it, though. Damping is fantastic, and that's always a weak point for any kind of performance-oriented hot hatch, and the Golf R does very well in that regard. Logically, I think there's no question. I think this is a wonderful all-around machine, and it's certainly the car I would choose today if I were out shopping. There's no question in my mind. I would get it in a very subtle, very quiet color, but yeah, this is it. And you know, even though it doesn't pull at my heartstrings, it's absolutely the logical choice and absolutely so much fun to drive. Thanks for watching this quick take on the Volkswagen Golf R. Hope you liked it. If you did, be sure to click like, share, and subscribe. And as always, we want to know what you think, so please leave a comment below. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again next time.